So we've gone through what Power BI Desktop is, what Power BI Service is, what Power BI Mobile and Power BI for Developers is. And you're probably wondering, how do all those pieces fit together? So this is exactly what we are going to do in this video. We're going to go a typical workflow on how to analyze data, and we will see how each component fits into that process. So how each component helps you get the solution that you need. And then at the end, I will do a live demo of Power BI so you can actually see it and feel it and say, oh, this is how it looks like. So we will do a quick report and we will go through each step so you can see how everything fits together. So first of all, workflow. How do we analyze data? And think about it, because you've done this when you've worked with Excel, but maybe you haven't reflected on it, because the processes are exactly the same except for the end. So the first thing you need to do is to get data, right? You have to get data into Power BI the same way you would get data into Excel. And to get data into Power BI, we've talked about this, you need Power Query. And you have two types of sources where you can get data from. You can get data from your local sources. That means Excel, text files, CSV. That will be also SQL on-premise, you know, everything that you have at your disposal locally. And then you have the possibility to get data from online sources. And Power BI, both the desktop and service, offers you a few connectors to do that. So you have, for example, on the service, the Google Analytics connector, you have MailChimp connector, you have Azure connector, both on the service and the desktop. So there are lots of ways to get data online. There is a really, really powerful connector called Web Connector that allows you to get data from websites. It's really, really, really good. And Microsoft is being perfecting this and it works really nice. You have to test that. If you need a connector that is not available there, you can actually create your own. There are a lot of developers that have been creating connectors for all kinds of things. For example, you have connectors for WooCommerce, and you have connectors for running applications, and there are connectors everywhere, you know, on GitHub, just Google it. But if you still can't find your connector, you can code your own. And you will do that using Power Query and the M language. If you don't know how to do it, you need to get help from some consultant firms, but it's absolutely possible to do. So now that we've got the data inside Power BI, the next thing we need to do is what we always do. We need to clean it. And think about it, you do this in Excel very, very often, if not always. Every time you get data in, you have to remove columns, remove products, or you have to change names, you have to... And all that, the data transformation, you've got a very powerful tool in Power BI to help you do that, and it's Power Query. Power Query is, by the way, available also in Excel. Make sure you use it. It's absolutely fantastic. So you have two ways to clean data. You can use the user interface, you know, the point and click. You have a lot of functions in there that do most of the jobs needed. But if you know a little bit of M, M is the language that Power Query uses to clean data, you can just code it. And M is a language that was created for Excel users. So you don't need to have any coding experience at all. You can actually learn M without any problem. And it is very, very intuitive. I found it very intuitive. Of course, it can get very complex, but for your daily clean need, your data clean needs is absolutely fantastic. You are going to really, really love it. So give it a go and try to learn M while you are at it. It will help you make more complex transformations. So now we've cleaned our data, the next thing we need to do is to model it, right? And we talked about it also in a previous video. You create a data model in Power BI. And it sounds a little bit fancy word, but you basically are doing, you know, in Excel, you normally would create a big table, right? You join tables, you join columns, and you do VLOOKUPs just to make a big table, and then you can start analyzing data. Well, in Power BI, you don't need to do that. You can leave your tables as they are, and you create relationships between the tables. If you work with Access a little bit, you will have very, very easy to do this. If you are not very experienced in doing these things, there are two things you can do. Number one, if your IT team has already created a model for you, for example, SQL database, when you import that data, the model will get imported too. So the relationships will get created automatically, and you don't need to worry about that. The second way is there is an option on Power BI which is turned on by default that is detect relationships. And Power BI will try to detect relationships between tables by itself. And it does a pretty good job at it. But, you know, sometimes it doesn't get it right. So if you see that things are getting filtered a little bit weird, it's probably that your relationships are not correctly set. But that is another tutorial for another day. So we have our data model in place, and now we need to ask questions. Both the data model and asking questions, you do it in Power Pivot. Again, you have it as an add-in in Excel. And DAX is a language that was created also for Excel users, and it uses the same terminology. So the functions sound the same. You have sum, you have count, you have count. Do you have count rows in Excel? I think you do. But you have the normal functions that you will find in Excel, which is a good thing because it gives you an idea of what it is or what that function does. But it doesn't work the same way. So I think that is a pity because you might think, oh, I know this function, I know what it does. But then you will find that when you start using it, it doesn't do what you think it should do. And complicates things a little bit. So, yes, DAX is not an intuitive language to learn. You have to really put time to learn it. But it is absolutely worth it. The upside of this is that you can create powerful reports without writing almost no DAX. Or any DAX at all, actually. And you'll show that on the example I'm going to show you at the end of this presentation. So you can still create really powerful reports without writing one line of DAX. That's really good, isn't it? But still, eventually, you will want to ask more powerful questions, and then you start needing to learn DAX. Okay, so now we have our data model, and we have all the measures, all the formulas that we need. And now we need to visualize our data, right? Visualize it and then share it. So to visualize it, we have a Power View in Excel, which is available in Power BI. And you have quite many visualizations inside Power BI out of the box. So you have line charts, you have bar charts, column charts, map charts, matrix, you know, tables, you have all kinds of visualizations. If for any reason the visualization that you want is not there, you can go to the Office Marketplace and try to find the visualization there. There are developers that are doing visualizations for Power BI, and most of them are free, but there are some premium visualizations also. If you still don't find your visualization, you can still create your own. We talk about it on Power BI for developers. So you can create your own visualizations using some type of JavaScript, okay? So, I mean, you can visualize anything anywhere. You still have R visualizations and Python visualizations if that's something that you know how to use. So you use all the visualizations, you create your report, and now it's time to share it to the world, right? So how do you do that? If you remember, you publish it to the service, to the cloud, and then you can share it with both publicly and internally, your colleagues, your friends, your partners, the web, whoever you want, no problem. You have the possibility to embed the report somewhere else, so you don't have to use PowerBI.com. You can just take your report and just put it in your app or on your platform or on your website or whatever you need. Or you can visualize your report on the mobile apps. We talked about that too. You have for iPhone and for tablets. So now you can start sharing your hard work with others and start learning insights, gaining insights from your data. So now that you know the workflow, how about we just do a practical case, right? We do a demo of how all those things work, step by step. Let's do that now.